The funniest thing is, like, during all the drone flights and all the inspections, you sometimes notice a particular piece of plastic. Maybe it's very big or very bright. And now in this pile, yeah, those pieces of plastic are there. So you get to know your pieces of plastic. You're like, oh, 2 days ago I saw this piece. It went in from the left side and then it got stuck there and there. But then that big wave came along and it pushed it on again. And it all came out so dramatically with everything bouncing off to all sides, like this mountain collapsing. We are recovering Jenny. We've deployed it 3 times. This is the 3rd recovery. As soon as Jenny is back on board, back in her little cradle, we're sailing back home to Victoria.
To go out there and do what we've done and catch over 8 tons of plastic with a system that wasn't functioning most of the time due to the camera skiff, it's amazing. And going forwards, we can make that a lot better. So we'll see what the next shift do. And I think they're gonna land even more plastic than we do.
Even though we did very few tests, the tests that we did do have showed us that we can consistently harvest plastic. And now we are going home with a good pile of plastics on the other boat and a working system behind our boat. That's actually quite a success.
So we are now about halfway the test campaign of System 2 Jenny in the Great Pacific Garbage Patch. And things are actually starting to look very, very promising, where the system is behaving well. And we see significant amount of trash coming on deck from these first few short tests that we've done so far. But we're not there yet. We still have a lot of tests to go. So we now make a brief stop in Canada to change the crew, and we should be back out again in about a week from now, when we'll be focusing on 2 things to complete the test campaign. One is that we're going to do tests with tagged plastic to see how efficient the cleanup system is. And then we're also going to do some longer duration tests. And now those, I think, will be very, very interesting, because if everything goes well, we might be able to see a system just completely filled with plastic during those tests. And of course, that's something we've been looking forward to for all these years. It will really be sort of the proof of the pudding that it's truly working and that we have a tool to clean up the patch. So either way, it's going to be very interesting. So fingers crossed for the next few weeks.
We are back in the port of Victoria. We are about to step onto land once again after being at sea for 6 weeks. We're good to go?
Yes, if you like.
Join me onto land.
It was a crazy experience. I've sailed for many years, but never been out in 6 weeks with not seeing shore. And you come in and you saw the mountains, and you could feel, yesterday we could feel the smell of shore. It's a different smell. So, and now I'm just here. And I didn't get land sick, you know, so that's good.
Oh man, it is weird. It's the craziest thing is when you walk, I walked outside this morning to change the GoPros, and I went, and you smell it.
This is good, this is definitely good. That's good, so, and 8.2 tons? That's good.
Most of the crew haven't been away from land for as long as we've just been. Even the captain, that was the first time he's ever been where he can't see land for 6 weeks. So yeah, this is new to most people.
And a decent cup of coffee.
Some of the other stuff and then get stuff right. So the plastic from offshore is landed here. It's been weighed offshore and now we weigh it a second time. So all the things are sealed. Fed is taking a video with the weight and the number of the container. I write it down and that's how we ensure the chain of custody. Yeah. Shift 2 will catch more. That's why Dan is on 2 shifts. So for sure he's on the one that catches the mud.